Take care of. Hey folks, I'm Mr. GG. Welcome back to Let's Play Romance of Three Kingdoms 13. I feel like I've already screwed this up. Like, we already took too long to launch our first attack because we don't know how many plot things there are going to be for us to take care of after we take Wudou. I figure Wudou and Tian Shui will be enough, but I don't know what plot stuff will occur after that. Let's see if we can go ahead and win this battle, and then we'll worry about whether we took too long to get in position to win it. I'm also realizing now we didn't take over any of these surrounding areas, including one that would have given us 500 farming, which we really should have attacked. But you either persuade them or you... I guess you can keep working on the rules. Well, these guys are going to continue farming as we fight, so that's nice, I guess. Taking them a little while to come after us. Battle of Wudou, Zhuge Liang against Guo Huai. I do want to control this battle directly, otherwise we have no freaking chance. I don't know how much chance we have. Troops have no permanence, water has no form. Okay, that's pretty crazy. So, I didn't really set up my army with as much care as I should have done. I got Iron Wall, greatly increases his own defense. I got Steel General, which increases defense, increases morale. He'll be a good one to lead off. With Brilliant Maneuver, greatly increases an ally's attack and defense, increases their morale, grants them strikes. Desperate Command, greatly increases an ally's attack and preserves some morale. And Stonewall Command, greatly increases an ally's defense. I don't know that I really organized the best army ever here. So let's start by attacking this camp and drawing those guys over here and then trying to find a way to fight them where we can maybe encircle them. What the hell are those? Tiger cavalry. Oh, fuck. Now you're backing up, huh? 请交给我吧。展现下一个策略。Oh, because now you guys are coming out. Gotcha. Alright, let's see back up here. Eventually, we want to... Do I really? I don't want to fight them in this camp, though. That guy's using attack command. I don't really like this positioning. Well, my guys are here. What skills have you guys got? Mighty Bow increases attack range. I got morale boost. I got cavalry charge. I can get my cavalry guys together and do a cavalry charge. That has worked well for us in the past. You are Eastern Infantry, though. Does cavalry charge have a... No, it's just him. It's not like everybody. Hopefully, I'll just have better officers than they got. Getting encircled here. Once Wudou did some damage there. Well, charging right through them did some damage, I guess. That's it for our morale, our tactical points now. Now's the time. Follow him. Are you still charging? Gotcha. Pincer attack this guy for whatever boost we get for that. Put his morale on the crapper, that was something. So we seem to be winning, but again, I don't know if we're winning fast enough. They want us to destroy the enemy gate. I'm sure we'll get to do that at some point.
Accept 全力一击吧
control to do that yet. Even more control to do that. Where are the rest of these guys? They're not even coming after me yet. So, if I defeat the army that's standing out, that's actually out here in the field, I'll have a couple of guys cowering behind the walls to deal with. And I might want to just come down here and head up this way, because they got more defenses up along here. You guys can help. Come on. Shit. The enemy's got reinforcements coming. That was too easy. Although I say it's too easy, even though I'm already also saying that I believe this has taken way longer than I was actually supposed to have. Saving up tactics now, I guess. Nobody's sneaking up on headquarters, though, so... That increases his own morale. That kind of sucks. Might be getting near time to get Zhu Liang in range to use his super tactics. Although we probably won't have time to execute him before he's wiped out. This is not how I fall. I'm going to fall in a totally different way. Now, once, well, you can sneak over here real quick and destroy this thing. Hopefully without taking too much damage. There goes Wen Pin, who I always thought had one of the cooler looking outfits. They still have a slight numerical advantage. We have a big morale advantage. As Guan Suo is possibly not a good use of his time, but at least he's out of the range of the siege weapons. Drive them back. Break their formation. Oh, and now they're coming through the middle. Okay, well. How about everybody except for Zhang Wei, whose unit's actually looking a little the worse for wear, comes back. Stop those guys from charging our main camp. I don't think they're going to... Oh, maybe they're going to try to take out Guan Suo because he's isolated. Oof, maybe that wasn't a good move on my part. Although he's fairly even with this guy. I could pretty much take him out here. You guys still might want to come up here and deal with that guy, though. And he just proved his fidelity to us. Can't really advance on his own. He's too badly outnumbered. We are going to have to figure out where we want to breach. So maybe we will breach over here. Alright, guys, so I'll head over towards this gate. Figure out a better plan as we get closer. I'm gonna get a pincer attack, though. Although, I could also do another cavalry charge right through both of them. What have you got, buddy? You have a siege ladder. Let's set up a siege ladder right there. Everyone else patiently wait to use it. Is it set up yet? Oh, he's still working on it. And that cavalry charge is pretty damn effective. Oh, we don't get to move over to that, huh? The wise and talented Jiang Wei take out that one remaining siege weapon so that we don't lose his troops, which are a bit lacking in manpower right now. I feel like he's going to take them out by himself here. Oh, whoa. Suddenly they're actually attacking. Shit. They were all just huddled up in their base. Back up. What happened to... Oh. Wei Yan is all the way back here. Shit. Oh, you got distracted. I don't know where these guys are going now. They're heading for my main base, or... Yeah, they're heading... heading for my main base. So I better stop them. Maybe Zhang Wei can be spared to go deal with this thing and give them another morale blow. Meantime, I kind of... Oh, a duel between the son of Guan Yu and the son of Pang De. This will be interesting. There's a little bit of personal animosity there after all, with the whole casket match and everything. Come, let us do battle. Fools, you actually thought you could beat me? Looks like the son of Guan Yu inherited a little bit more battle skill than the son of Pang De did. Although he's gathering his will, seems kind of dumb. Hopefully he'll use a super here and finish this. So this will be an exciting video, even if I'm still not sure that I've got enough time left to finish everything else I need to do. I really don't want any units getting wiped out, particularly not Zhuge Liang. Brilliant Maneuver uses 8 control, so that's going to be tough. So that Zhang Hu is going after Zhang Wei. There's a personal animosity there. Either way, they now believe that we are going to win. We've got the You Are Going to Win music playing. Now, do not pause. Move in. Their morale is like zilt, so hopefully they won't be able to do anything with that camp. That pincer attack really fouled him up pretty bad. And my favorite move, counter charge. One of them is about to get wiped out. Everyone is still ticking up here. I guess we won't get to see Zhuge Liang's tactic. There's no time. Eastern infantry can come up here and take out that thing because it's bothering me. I guess we got Zhang Hu. Well, I don't think there's time for you guys to help out with that fight, so I'm taking out this camp for some silly reason. Oh no, actually you can finish these guys off because they're now running in fear from Guan Suo back towards their own city, which has already been taken. Get back here, you cowards. Trying to pincer attack, I might not be able to before he's defeated. This is not a life ball. Oh, units decimated. Just as I thought, bitches. Wei Yan wins the day, which surprised me because Guan Suo, I thought, pretty much handled that fight on his own.
Well done. You ranked first. I have yet to see such bravery as yours.
One spear, fast as mine. No sweat.
Tactics are one thing, victory is another. I must learn from my mistakes. Using Serious JG as my Let's Player, thank you all for your aid. Pray for the next battle goes just as well. I'm praying for a healthy battle. Praying to Jesus, the space station.
Yeah, Guan Suo, I would have thought, would have had more deeds than he did, but it's all good. So I definitely want to move officers. I should have saved. Well, I don't really have time to save, but I feel like there's nothing left for this city to do. We have to move officers out of here and leave like one or two caretakers. Obviously want Zhuge Liang. Obviously want Zhang Wei. I want Wei Yuan. Because these guys are going to be doing some more fighting. Think my die. Guan Jing. Guan Suo for sure. Let's see what people's tactics are. Cavalry charge is a good one. Slow horses, reduce enemy armor. Burn. Ooh. I don't know about him. She's not bad. Strength attack, weaken attack, stonewall, cavalry charge. Another guy with cavalry charge. That's a good one. Fire burst, using enemies morale and troops counts. How many people have that I've selected now? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Wow, man. Increase defense slightly. Increases on defense, slightly increases morale, and grants desperation. What are her stats? Not the worst war officer ever. Although not as good as Bao Sainan. Oh, misinformed provocation is a good one to have for sure. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How many total do we have? I don't remember. 15 in one city and 18 in the other, I think. People who did not come along on that last combat, I should probably consider, are not the greatest combat guys ever. Oh, I did not mean to do that. Shoot, I just unselected it. Anyway, so my total is, I got a total of 33 to spread. So if I leave 3 here, I could use 15 in each. So, shoot. Guys, um, 6, 7, 8, then I need like 7 from the other city. I'm going to set aside, I want to take some of these guys along too. Okay, so I don't have to be as panicky as I was a minute ago. The ladies would be fun, but I don't know if they're really the smartest ones to bring. Looking for people with skills that'll be useful in battle. Burn is good, but what are your stats looking like? Now you're not a very good war officer, otherwise. Cavalry, yeah, you for sure. Mighty bow. We'll bring along you so we've got a good bow unit. This year. Alright, let me just get people with I was trying to get good leader stats. I would have 13, 13, 7. Okay, here's how I want to do it. I want to grab 7 people out of here. I grab 2 more out of here.
Goofy verse.
Maybe somebody with some good governance. Finally figured out my buttons and what they're doing, really. That'll give us a couple of people hanging around in Jitong just to keep the city running. And we'll have 15 people in each of our 2 frontline cities. And I'll have to reset ministers and shit. The order to transfer to Wudou has been confirmed. Due to certain conditions, the assignment given to Jitong has been aborted. For capturing Wudou, Lord Liu Shan has conferred onto you the rank of Prime Minister. But I was king, king of Hanzhong. Very well, expect my deepest are you well, sir? Sire? His meal is simply not agreed with him. I will take care of him, so you may take your leave. Yes.
对不起.
Forgive me, I'll be all right. Everything is going to be all right. Rockabye. I had imagined you were feeling unwell, but to be this ill, perhaps if you rested. No, I'll be fine. I do not have much time left after all. Surely you joust. I can tell when my body's amiss. I know I have put a few years
but a few years left in this world. That can't be. There is no time. We must march as soon as the army has... There is no time. We march as soon as the army has is prepared for battle. As soon as the army has is prepared for battle, launch every zig. Chang'an would be the best base for our advance east. However, it boasts a mighty defense. Let us start with Tian Shui. I see. If we have both Wudou and Tian Shui, we can attack Changsha from both sides. Indeed. Now we must be wary of Sima Yi and Chang'an. It is no exaggeration to say he is our greatest obstacle. Understood. I will let everyone know that we are to attack Tian Shui then. Zhang Wei, there is one thing I must tell you. The Northern Campaign. I will not live to see the end of it. Even if we overcome this trial, our road of struggle will continue for a long, long time, paved with the blood of many. Even so, are you truly ready to follow this path, to climb piles of dead for the ideals of a dead man to whom you owe no allegiance?
Sure.
Yes. As you owe a debt to Lord Liu Bei, I owe a debt to you. Furthermore, it is clear that His Majesty Liu Shan is the only one justified in sitting on the Imperial Throne. Really? Are you speaking of the same Liu Shan I know? To turn away from the righteous path would be sheer cowardice, even if it cost me my life. I will not stray. I will not resign. See, I'm thinking of Dynasty Warriors 5, Jian Wei's voice, which wasn't all that distinctive or that different from Zhuge Liang, so it's really throwing me off. I should be shouty DW7 onward, Jian Wei. How foolish.
Ah, I try to emulate you!
Then at the very least, I shall impart to you all the secrets of the courts and of war that I can.
I'm honored!
Bond created. The Inheritor.
Zhuge Liang and Jiang Wei have formed the bond, the Inheritor, level 5. Isn't marriage only level 4? Goofy.
Hey, look, there's Jinxai over there. Whatever she's called in this game. You can see she's got a relationship with her mother. And I don't know who that guy is off to the right, but she's married to Liu Chan. That's Jinxai right over there. Zhuge Liang's skill speed is leveled up, and Zhang Wei's strategy skill is leveled up. Increase your territory's farms, gather supplies, and hurry to conquer Tian Shui. Well, I'm curious now about the... So Zhang Shi is what the character known in Dynasty Wars as Jinxai is known as in Romance of Three Kingdoms. Xi Hao Shi is her mother. Liu Shan is her husband. So who's this? This is Zhang Shao. Zhang Fei's second son. Oh, okay. So that's her brother. He and Cao Zhao handed the imperial seal to Deng Ai when Shu surrendered. He followed Liu Shan in his move to Liu Yang after Zhang Hui's death and was praised by Li Hui. Got you. He's not super awesome character or anything like that. Guess she's still alive and was still working for Shu. Xiao Yuan's niece and Zhang Fei's wife was captured by Zhang Fei. When looking firewood at the age 14, and was made his wife. Buried Xiao Yuan's body after he fell in battle. And there's Jinxai herself, Zhang Fei's oldest daughter, Liu Shan's empress. Passed away after 16 years in the court, leading Liu Shan to marry her younger sister. Well, that is supposed to be the blade she uses in Dynasty Wars. So presumably. Jinxai is supposed to be the older sister. And we have Yue Ying, who for some reason... Like, where is she? She's in Chengdu. Why isn't she part of our, like, army in this battle? That would have been sweet, actually, if we could have Yue Ying participating in battle with us. But we can't. So, move on. We're going to save our game. I'm not saving in the very first slot, because that is the slot reserved for when we first began this whole mess. And I have a feeling we might be starting over from the very beginning. Because amongst other things, we didn't bother to suppress a nearby village. It would have given us 500 farming in one shot, which we should have done. I guess I could still try to order somebody to do that. But the farming would go to a place that has now manually maxed out its farming. This is going to be the end of my session. So even though this video has already gone long, we can take just a minute to note that
Well, Wudu's got no soldiers, but in a moment, these armies will be... Well, I guess once these armies disperse... they don't... Yeah, I would say they only have 60-some food. Otherwise, I'm like, do I want to go for some crazy shit where I launch an attack right away? No, I'd be outnumbered 4-1, and I wouldn't have... and I've already used most of my food, so that's not going to work. So, it's plus 750 farming. That might be worth taking over for Wudou. Wudou has negative revenue. Great. Maybe that will... Oh, because I've got too many officers there. So I'm going to have to work on commerce just to avoid running out of money. Or I can do the old transfer all the food, the money's from other places trick. Because at this point, Jitong will probably never use its food anymore, or its money. So I could transfer the money out of Jitong and into Wudou. Food-wise, they have 10,000 supplies. That's not very much. That's actually less than this city has. I was counting on having all that food, but I suppose it had to occur to me that the defenders of the city that I just defeated were going to take the food with them. So maybe real quick before we do anything else, I could what is we doing here first, gold or food? Leave you guys enough gold to pay your officers for a couple of months, I guess. Matter of fact, I probably need to leave more than that. And then switch over supplies. So now they've got almost 12,000 gold, which means that we can afford to be running at a loss for a little while, but not all that long, actually. I'm going to have to get commerce up in this city. That'll wait till next time. So I'll save over the slot that I just did, and when we come back... Don't know how much time we have. Again, this video is going freaking long, and now I want to check the time remaining on this whole shooting gallery here. It is May 30. Basically, it's the end of May. So we got June, July, August, September, October, November, December. We got 7 months before the end of 233. We have until AD December 30th, 234. So we've got about a year and a half. The problem is, we don't really know exactly what we're expected to do. So, I feel like we're probably not supposed to use Hanzhong troops to take Tian Shui, but I really am not sure. As far as military goes, it's troops aren't too bad. Returning troops, wounded. There's 64,000 wounded, which means that we'll get a decent troop count in this city with which to attack Tian Shui eventually. It's going to come down to whether or not we've got enough food. So hopefully we can figure that out. As this whole campaign is a desperate battle to have enough supplies to field any kind of army. And that'll continue next time on the Mysterious GG. Thanks for watching. We'll see